In this lesson, we're talking about threads and concurrency. So how might one visualize these concepts? Well, one way you might think of threads is that each thread is like a worker in a toy shop. But what qualities make a worker in a toy shop similar to a thread? The first quality is that a worker in a toy shop is an active entity. Secondly, a worker in a toy shop works simultaneously with others. And finally, a worker in a toy shop requires coordination, especially when multiple workers are working at the same time and perhaps even contributing to the same toy order. Let's elaborate on these points now. A worker is an active entity in the sense that it's executing a unit of work that's necessary for a given toy order. Many such workers can contribute to the entire effort required for an actual toy to be built. Next, a worker can simultaneously work with others. This is pretty straightforward. You can imagine a shop floor with many workers all simultaneously or concurrently hammering, sewing, building toys at the same time. They may be working on the same order or on others. And finally, while the workers can work simultaneously, this comes with some restrictions. Workers must coordinate their efforts in order to operate efficiently. For instance, workers may have to share tools, they may have to share some working areas, their workstations, or even parts while they're in the process of making toys and executing the toy orders. Now that we know about workers in a toy shop, what about threads? How do they fit into this analogy? First, threads are also active entities, except in this case, threads execute a unit of work on behalf of a process. Next, threads can also work simultaneously with others, and this is where the term concurrency really applies. For instance, in modern systems that have multiple processors, multiple cores, you can have multiple threads really at the exact same time executing concurrently. But this obviously will require some level of coordination. And specifically, when we talk about coordination, we're really mainly talking about coordinating access to the underlying platform resources. Sharing of I/O devices, the CPU cores, memory, all of these and other systems resources must be carefully controlled and scheduled by the operating system. This begs the question, how do we determine which thread gets access to these resources? And as you will see in this lesson, the answer to the question is very important design decision for both operating systems as well as software developers in general.